Hello everybody and welcome to this channel. On this episode I'm going to introduce to you a magnificent Persian palace known as Hasht Behesht, so stay tuned. Hasht Behesht mansion, which was once called the most spectacular palace in the world, was built in 1669 during the time of Shah Suleiman Safavid and has 5,000 square meters floor area. This place also was the first royal frontistry of the Qajar period in Isfahan city, known as Humayuni. The vast garden in which the mansion is located was a part of the Great Garden of Naqsh-e-Jahan that was built by Shah Ismail I and was divided into several parts during the time of his successors. Hasht Behesht Garden existed during the time of Safavid kings, and at the behest of them, miscellaneous trees were added to this picturesque garden. The construction process was completed in the third year of Shah Suleiman's reign, and according to historical evidence, this octagonal garden was the residence place of king's family as well, where four people, often men, lived on the ground floor and four others, usually women, lived on the first floor. This two-story building with beautiful arches and many decorations is considered one of the brilliant examples of Safavid era architecture, and due to its scenic view, it's been analogized to heaven. The central part of the palace is built in four rows and its porch faces the north. The cupola of its roof that rests on top of this two-story building is covered with colorful plaster motifs, geometrical designs, and impressive paintings. The rooms on the ground floor in the four corners of the building are embellished with stucco and paintings. On the first floor of the building, arches, windows, and natural lights double its beauty. The floor is divided into several corridors and rooms. Each of them has special decorations. Some have water tanks and others have fireplaces. The walls are also covered with mirror tiles. What is important in this building is the connection between its different parts. This connection made this building have integrity in its structure despite the diversity and multiplicity of spaces. The ornaments of the mansion during the Safavid era were so superb and artistic that many tourists admired it. By passing time, many changes were made, especially during the Qajar period, and at the end of this epoch, Hasht Behesht mansion became private property. Nonetheless, the exquisite and precious ornaments of the Safavid era, the grandeur and alluring beauty of inside the palace, the fountains and the flowing water streams, have remained, so far as the Western archaeologists stated that Hasht Behesht Palace, with a hall that is open from all sides and a pavilion in its center, still retains the original and brief combination of grace and elegance of the past. The design of this octagonal palace was so majestic that its architecture has been widely imitated in building other royal residences as well. There are some Iranian architectural principles that you can observe in this section. For instance, symmetrical designs, using natural elements like trees, flowers, and ponds, applying grid windows that look like lattice and work as a ventilation additionally, allocating a separate place for men and women, designing distinct winter and summer resorts, and last but not least, using arch forms in the structure of building.
Thanks for watching. I hope you enjoyed this episode. Let me know your opinion in the comment section, and if you like, please subscribe to my channel and wait for new videos.